guys, welcome back to my channel. So like I said last time, I talked about the importance of reviewing your goals midway. So today I'm going to review my goals with you guys, and I hope you can learn something from these goals and also try to also see how you can review your own. So the first goal that I had for this year was to save a certain amount of money, but then I have since revised that goal. So I've decided to reduce the amount of money that I want to save, because I want to invest more than I want to save. So I got this idea that I think I want to invest in. So that means that I'll take away from some of the money that I initially set out to save. So that's my first adjustment to my goal. So the money that I set out to save is going to be less, but then I'm going to increase on my investments. Then the second goal was to pay my daughter's fees by July. I think that's going well, and I think I'll be able to do that. We haven't yet reached the month end of July, so we still have time. So I think I'm going to be able to achieve that goal. So the reason for making that goal was because most of us parents have pressure when schools are opening in January, and I want to try and avoid that pressure. So I want to find out from you guys, do you usually set goals for fees for your kids? And if you do, how is that going? Are we going to be together in January just slaying and not even like thinking about school? I hope we can do that together. Then my other goal that I put was that I want to be faithful in tithes and offerings. That's something, I don't know if I've already done a video about it, but it's something that I'm going to do a video on, because I want to, there's just something that I want to share with you guys, something that happened to me that I learned from, and a video that I watched that talked about putting God first, even through your tithes and offerings. And it's something that I wanted to improve on this year, and I think I have. So yeah, I think I'm doing well here. Then the second thing was that I wanted to get insurance for myself, like medical insurance, life insurance, something like that. But then something also happened. Coincidentally, I already have now that insurance, and I'm happy about that. Although I didn't really work hard towards this goal, it's something that just happened. And then the other thing, I wanted to figure out whether I could invest in insurance, like as a way of making a profit, and as well as stock and bonds. So I was supposed to do my research by March, which I did, and I decided that I wasn't going to go that route through the research that I did and the people that I talked to. But if you still want to convince me to try and do it, you can hit me up, let me know why you think it's a good idea to invest in stock and bonds. Yeah, but then from my research, I'm not going to do it. And the other thing was that if I was to go ahead with that, I was supposed to start investing in that by 31st October. But then since it's something that I'm not looking into, so that goal has changed. Then the other goals that I put, this one is for me and my friends. We had put that we want to do like 2 mini vacations within the country. And we're supposed to do one like in the first half of the year. And June has already passed. We didn't do it. So I think we're going to sit down as a group and figure out what happened, where we went wrong, and then try to just review that and see how best we can do it, or just do it as soon as possible. Then the other goal that I put, this one was just about eating, taking myself out. But then because I like eating, I think it was kind of like an excuse for me to eat more. And I know I wasn't going to fail this goal, and I'm actually doing very well. I'm happy about that. I think I should actually increase it. I think it's so easy. Maybe I should just up it, like to try and eat different cuisines. I'm not a seafood fan, but my friends want me to try seafood, so I'm going to try it again and eat what she's going to recommend and see how that goes. So I think I'm going to change these goals for the second half of the year to just make them a bit more specific in terms of food, like maybe try out different cuisines and stuff like that. Then the other goal that I had was to read 24 books this year. I think that was like, I think that's also another goal that I think I'm going to manage. I'm not going to change it though. So once I reach 24 goals, I think, yes, I'll be happy that I've met my target. I can read more, but I'm not changing it to like 30 books or anything. I'm currently on my 19th book, so 5 more to go, and I'm going to reach my goal of 24 books. Then the other goals that I had were relationship goals. I think I'm doing well with these, although after looking at them, I decided that I'm supposed to kind of review them. I want to review them to make them a bit more specific. So relationship goals are goals for my relationships with my family, my friends, as well as business partners. So that's something that I want to review to just make them a bit more specific. But the ones that I set out are going quite okay. Then I set out my some goals for the organizations that I belong to, and some of my duties, which are Sunday school teaching, the Girls Brigade, and the Cooper Young Women's Network. So with the Sunday school teaching, I set like 7 goals and I've only done 2 out of those 7. So this is something that I really need to work on. I didn't put timelines for the things. So what I've decided now is to put timelines for them. Like I should do this by this. I knew I put like by the end of the year I should do these things. But I think if I kind of spread them out through the remaining 6 months, that will work out better for me. Then for the Girls Brigade, I managed to do the things that I wanted to do, which was get a teaching plan and attend some meetings. I wanted to attend 6 meetings. I think I attended my 5th meeting this weekend. So I have 1 more meeting. So I think I'm doing well there, except we had set goals as a group, individual goals, and we're supposed to track them. I think that's something that we are slacking on. And since I've reviewed my goals this year, we're going to also review our personal goals as a group next week. And then I also try to enhance our reading goals. Then my other goal was to read the Bible in a year. I've also changed that goal. I'm going to try and read the Bible in 2 years this year because I don't know. I just feel like when I read the Bible in hard copy and soft copy, it's different. So I want to now read more of hard copy, which is in the morning. So in the morning, right now with my morning routine, it's hard to do 4 chapters in the morning, which is how much I need to read on average to read the Bible in a year. So I usually read between 1 and 2. Sometimes I reach 4, but then just I don't want to stress and I just want to read it at my own pace. As long as I put in the hours, the minutes in the morning. So that's what I want to do. I'll do it in 2 years. But otherwise with the revised goal, it's going well. Then I'm supposed to also memorize 40 memory verses. This is not going well. Because I'm supposed to do 20 by now, and I'm struggling with one that I did a chapter last year, Psalm 91, which is one of my favorite Psalms. And this year, I think I was trying to say it the other day and I didn't manage to say all of it. So I think I need to work on this goal. Then the other one is that I'm supposed to post 24 videos on my YouTube channel. I think I'm going to meet this goal. I haven't been consistent. I hope I can just try a bit more to be a bit more consistent, but then consistency wasn't my goal. My goal was to post 24 videos, so I hope I can catch up with those, yes, and just try to be a bit more consistent. Even if it wasn't my goal, it could be my goal for the second half of the year. Then the other one, my health goals now. One of my health goals is that I should get like my proper BMI, which is 25. And it's not looking good. But then I've kind of come up with my more solid morning routine or workout routine, which is going quite well. So I'm happy about that. Then my other goal was that I wanted to run a marathon. So this goal, I'm revising it because I don't know why I want to run a marathon. I just put it there because I think I've seen it on a number of people's goals. So I just want to change it, like to just put something that I would actually want to do. So I want to work out and do something through my workout schedule, but then running is not really my thing. Yeah, okay, we'll see. I'm still thinking about it, but then I don't know why I put that I wanted to run a marathon, really. I feel like, you know, when you make goals, you need to have a why. Then the other one is that I wanted to visit the dentist. You know, I haven't yet visited my dentist this year. I don't even have a dentist, but I haven't yet visited any dentist this year. So hopefully I can do it next weekend or the other weekend. But then by the end of July, I need to do it because on my goals, I was supposed to do it in February. It's something that I overlooked. I don't want to make excuses because there's a reason why I didn't go. But then I think if I really wanted to go, I was just going to find a way around that. So I hope I can go by the end of this month. Then I was also supposed to do a health checkup by March, which I didn't do. So I need to couple these two together and do that. Then I had a couple of work goals, which I'm revising almost all of them because, I'm just going to revise all of them because, you know, it's a matter of leveling up. Then I'm supposed to do 12 online courses. I've only done 2. And the 2 I've done, the one is a demo course on how to use edX. I use edX for my online courses. I haven't done a demo course yet, and I did that. And I'm counting it as a course because it was time that I invested in and energy and effort. So, yeah, I need to improve on my online courses. So I've only done 2, but I'm supposed to do 12. I think I overestimated this, but I don't want to reduce it again. I'll see, maybe I can find easy ones that I can do in a short time and just be able to do the 12 still. And then the other thing that I wanted to do was to just be a bit more on LinkedIn. That's a social media account that I rarely use, but then now I want to use that more. So those are my goals, and that's how I've decided to review them. Let me know about your goals, or if any of my goals are similar to yours, and how you're going to review yours, or if you're just going to maintain the goals that you started out with. But I'm definitely going to change mine and just add more. I feel like, you know, when I made these goals, they seemed like a lot, and, you know, I was excited about them. But then now looking at them, I feel like I need to add a lot more. Not a lot more, but some more goals to these goals. So let me know how yours are going. Thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe to my channel. I hope you're encouraged. Bye.